TVS Motor Company is no stranger to the commuter motorcycle segment in India. With bikes like the Star City, Victor, and to an extent even the Fiero, TVS had in the past cemented its place as one of the best in the commuter motorcycle segment in India. Now, TVS has developed a new premium commuter motorcycle. It's brand new and is a global motorcycle. Hello and welcome to DriveSpark. I'm Stephen Neal and this is the new TVS Raider. It marks TVS's return to the 125cc segment and we are here at the company's facility in Hosur to find out what it's all about. So, let's go and take a ride. As aforementioned, the TVS Raider is a brand new motorcycle built on a new platform. But the design inspiration seems to have been drawn from the TVS Apache RTR 164V. Now that being said, let's go take a look at the details. Let's start by talking about the front end. So you've got this LED headlamp up front, you've got the LED low beams, high beams, and also you've got these unique LED DRLs. It makes the motorcycle, especially in this shade of yellow, look like a certain character from a certain well-known movie. Let's not get there. But then above it, you've got this small fly screen and you've also got the LCD instrument cluster. And that pretty much sums up the front end of the motorcycle. You've also got the TVS Remora tires. The pattern on the tires also adds a certain flair to the front end of the motorcycle. And also you've got the bash plate under the engine and that adds to the overall design from the front end as well. Now let's take a look at the side profile. This is the side profile of the TVS Raider and straight off you can see the different colors at play here. Now, talking of colors, there are multiple color options in which you can have the bike and this is in the shade of yellow. Of course, there are different colors in this motorcycle itself. So you've got the bright yellow there on the tank and other different parts on the motorcycle. Then you've got the gloss black on the fuel tank extension on the fairing. And then you've got the matte gray finish on that same extension as well as on the rear end. And then of course, you've got the aluminum finish on the exhaust. So it's a lot of colors at play here and it makes the motorcycle look that much more attractive. It gives it that premium feel that TVS is aiming at. Now, let's talk about the side profile, the design, what are the elements that stand out. Firstly, you've got the petal disc brake up front and then of course you've got the same bash plate that we talked about earlier. In that shade of yellow, it really stands out, it's really bright. And then you've got the engine itself, it's a brand new 125cc unit, we'll be talking about that in just a bit. And the design detail on that is the air cooling vents, not just on the cylinder but also on the side casing. So that looks really nice as well. And then you've got the Raider badge on the side panel. And then of course the exhaust sounds lovely, we'll be talking about that as well, but it looks really nice as well in that aluminium finish and it gets a dual tone overall kind of finish and that really sums up the side profile of the TVS Raider. It is a rather simple affair at the rear end of the TVS Raider. It is a premium commuter, so there are a few premium elements, but otherwise it's really simple. You've got the LED tail lamps and that is what makes it stand out. That is the premium element at the rear. It's in this unique shape and that makes it really stand out. Also, you've got the grab rails and they're finished rather well. And then of course your attention is drawn to the sari guard. It is rather large, but also it's utilitarian. It's just not the sari guard, but the side step as well is built into the sari guard and that makes it great purely for commuting. And then of course you've got the contrasting rear footrest and then you've got the sporty chain half cover that sets it apart from the other commuters in the segment. And well, that pretty much sums up the rear end of the TVS Raider. The TVS Raider comes with just enough features to give the premium commuter tag. And let's start off with the LED lighting. You've got the LED headlamp and LED tail lamp. That takes care of the LED bit. You also got the halogen powered indicators. We feel those could have been LEDs too. Now let's talk about the instrumentation. It's a negative LCD unit and it displays a whole lot of information. You get the trip meters, you get the taco, the odo, the speedo. It displays the time, it displays the ride modes, etc. And there's a whole lot more. Now this LCD is offered on this variant that we're riding, but TVS will offer a bigger 5-inch TFT instrument cluster. It displays more information and is also capable of connecting to your smartphone via TVS's SmartX Connect system. We haven't got our hands on it yet, but we will be doing a full road test soon, so stay tuned for that. You move a little back and then you look at the new switch gear. It feels more premium, it feels tactile, it's easy to use. So on the left side, you've got the pass switch, the headlamp, high beam, low beam switch, and also you've got the horn switch. On the right side though, you've got a new switch. It's for the ride mode. You can switch between eco and power mode in a jiffy. You also got the starter button. It's a one touch starter. It's very easy to use. It starts really quick and very quietly as well. But we did miss a kill switch. So that is something that TVS could have provided on this motorcycle. Now let's talk about the charger. You get a USB outlet here that you can use to charge up your smartphone. And then let's talk about the underseat storage. It's a very neat underseat storage, probably one of the best we have seen in this segment. You can easily organize your things in here. You can place your smartphone or your toolkit, medical kit, whatever you feel like in here. It's small, but it's very organized. So that's something that we really liked. And that just about wraps up the features on the TVS Raider. Time to talk about the specs. Firstly, let's talk about the engine. You've got a 124.8cc single cylinder air and oil cooled engine. It puts out 11.2 bhp at 7500 rpm and 11.2 nm at 6000 rpm. A 5-speed gearbox handles transmission duties. Now this engine is air and oil cooled. The oil cooling is internal, which signifies great engineering in this price bracket. Let's talk about suspension and brakes. Speaking about the suspension, it gets a 30mm telescopic fork up front, and then at the rear, it gets a 5-step preload adjustable monoshock. And braking is handled by a 240mm disc brake up front and a 130mm drum brake at the rear. That pretty much sums up the specs of the TVS Raider. What does it all translate to while you're riding it? Let's find out.
The difference that this new engine makes is felt the moment you thumb the one-touch starter button. The integrated starter generator gives the motorcycle a rather premium feel. The bike produces a deep, bassy soundtrack. We rode the motorcycle on TVS's test track located inside the brand's Hosur production facility. The TVS Raider is powered by a 124.8cc single-cylinder air and oil-cooled engine. It has a maximum power output of 11.2 brake horsepower at 7,500 rpm and a peak torque output of 11.2 Nm at 6,000 rpm. A 5-speed gearbox drives the rear wheel. The output isn't much when looked at on the whole. However, it is the fourth most powerful 125cc motorcycle on sale in India. At 123 kilograms, the TVS Raider even weighs less. On the saddle, this translates to a fun experience. Acceleration is brisk, and before you know it, you're past 60 kilometers per hour. Even 90 kilometers per hour comes up pretty soon, but the acceleration slows down after that. TVS claims a top speed of 99 kilometers per hour, but we managed to clock 107 kilometers per hour on the speedo. This, however, was in a crouched, tucked-in position on the long straight. In an upright riding position, we did 101 kilometers per hour. The upper half of the rider's body is in a relaxed position, while the lower half takes up a sportier posture. This also allows the rider to grip the fuel tank very well. We also found that the motorcycle was very flickable and agile. This is bound to be a boon in the urban jungle. The low end torque is great and it pulls from as low as 2000 rpm in fifth gear, and this aids rideability further. Should you decide to take it out on the open road, the motorcycle does 70 km per hour at 5000 rpm and 90 km per hour comes up at around 6500 rpm. Cruising at 90 km per hour might be a little too stressful, but 70 to 75 km per hour is doable over longer distances. The suspension setup is more towards the softer side, and this takes away the stability while cornering at high speed. However, it was a fun experience trying to push the motorcycle on the long right-hander at the TVS test track. The brakes are powerful as well. It comes with a 240mm petal disc up front and a 130mm disc at the rear, complemented by a combined braking mechanism. The TVS Raider rides on 17-inch alloy wheels shod with TVS Eurogrip Remora tires. We have to push down really hard on the rear brake lever to get the wheel to lock up. The front end just kept gripping on the track. It remains to be seen how they perform on the road. On the whole, the TVS Raider boasts brilliant ride quality and fun-to-ride characteristics.
After riding the motorcycle for quite some time, here are a few things that we liked about the new TVS Raider. Firstly, let's talk about the design. The colors, the design, the body panels, everything gel well together. In fact, there are a few other colors that the motorcycle is sold in, and they look really attractive too. So the styling is the first thing that we liked about the motorcycle. And then you've got the power to weight ratio. The motorcycle has a power output of 11.2 bhp, which is really good for a commuter motorcycle, especially in the 125cc segment. And then you've got the weight, which is just 123 kilograms, and that makes this motorcycle really agile and really fun to ride, especially out here on the track. We will be riding it out on the road soon, but we do have a hunch that this will be fun out on the road too. And then you've got the features. For a motorcycle in this price bracket, in this segment, the bike is really packed with features. You've got the LCD screen. Of course, LCD screen already displays a lot of information. And then you've got the TFT that will be offered on the top spec model. That will bring in more information to the rider. And that is packing the motorcycle with features. You also got the USB charger. So it feels really premium to have these features on the motorcycle. Finally, you've got the braking. The brakes are really good. The pedal disc brake up front provides really good stopping force. And the rear brake too, surprisingly, even though it's a 130mm drum brake, it provides really good stopping force. The progression is great. The bite could have been better, but on the whole, it feels really nice. So these are the things that we liked about the TVS Raider. There are a couple of things that could have been better with the TVS Raider. Firstly, you got the fit and finish. The motorcycle looks great, make no mistake. But of course, you've got a few niggles here and there, and an eye for detail will go straight to those niggles. There are a few exposed welds that don't really look nice, and then you've got some squeaking noises coming out of the motorcycle already. So that is something that could have been better. We're sure that will improve over time though, since this is a brand new motorcycle on a brand new platform. Then of course, you've got the indicators. Everything on the motorcycle is premium and looks great. You've got the LED headlamp and tail lamp, but the indicators are not LEDs. LED indicators could have made the whole package so much more sweeter. Commuter motorcycles have come a long way from their bare basic and utilitarian beginnings, and the TVS Raider is proof of just that. With premium features and a butter smooth powertrain, this motorcycle seems all set to rule the competition in the premium commuter segment. Well, our first look at the motorcycle has definitely left us impressed. We'll be doing a full road test soon to bring you all the details, so stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. I'm Stephen Neal, signing off for DriveSpark. Also, you've got the... Please go away. Three, two, one. Flights.